everyone. My name is Jenny Wang, a student of Management 106 in Lincoln University. Today, I'm going to talk about one topic, the application of QR code in food safety. In this presentation, it includes three parts. First, I will explain what is QR code. And second, I will give the reason why I choose this topic and how it influences people's life nowadays. And finally, I will give an example to explain it in detail. Well, what's the QR code? Basically, it means two-dimension code. The application of QR code in food safety tracing systems helps consumers to get all of the information of a particular product and every aspect in the processing of manufacture. Look at the picture on the screen. It's very easy for consumers to use their mobile phone and then to scan the label on the package. The function of the QR code in one label of the products is similar with the function of ID cards for every person. Well, these Chinese characters means food safety could be traced. Well, this slide shows the reasons why I choose this topic. First of all, I think consumers' demand is the most important reasons. Because nowadays, more and more consumers are concerned about where the products originally come from, and they want to analyze whether the product is organic food, natural food or not, and then to make sure the quality of the food. The second reason is about food safety. It is the tracing way, and in this system, it involves some parts, such as farmers, industries, supermarkets, and the retailers, consumers. The third reason is about QR code is now a computer technology. You could imagine that as a consumer, you stand in front of the shelves of in the supermarket. It's very easy for you, and also it is very convenient for you to use your smartphone, whether your phone is iOS cooperating systems or Android cooperating systems. Only use your smartphone to scan the label on the package of a product. Well, this slide shows an example about pork product processing. The left part shows the food safety tracing. Well, the QR code could be along with the whole life of one pig in the farms. When the pig grown at a certain size, it could be sent to meat processing plant through the transport systems and then wholesalers. Finally, the consumers could get the meat product from the retailers. Well, the left part shows in order to complete this system, it involves different occupations such as farmers, transporters, manufacturers, retailers, and consumers. Well, this is the reference which supports my presentation. And nowadays, this new technology has been applied in many places, such as Shanghai City, Henan Province, and Guangdong. Thanks for watching.